CBS The Bold and the Beautiful spoilers an update for Thursday, February 4th, teases that Steffi Forster will turn to someone who loves her unconditionally. Steffi will really need to talk to her dad, so she'll open up to Ridge Forster and get some much-needed support. Ridge will hear the story of Steffi's steamy night with Liam Spencer, which started with Liam's mannequin confusion and ended with a drunken hookup. Steffi will admit that she's pregnant and uncertain of whether the father is Liam or Dr. Finn, though she definitely wants the baby to be Finn's. Band spoilers say Ridge will have to wrap his head around all that, but he'll quickly move past his shock and express happiness over Kelly Spencer's little brother or sister. Ridge will be excited for Steffi to have another bundle of joy, so he'll be trying to focus on the positive aspects here. Of course, Ridge will get that the paternity mystery isn't ideal. He'll hate the fact that Steffi's feeling so worried at a time when she should be over the moon. Since Steffi will want Finn to be the father, that's what Ridge will want, too. They'll both hope that Steffi can put this paternity nightmare behind her once some Finn baby daddy proof comes in. Ridge won't judge Steffi for her one-night stand with Liam, but he may fret over Liam's hold on his daughter. There could be concerns about Liam reeling Steffi back in, playing games with her heart. Ridge might also worry about Finn's commitment if this baby doesn't turn out to be his own, but Finn will do his part to ease Ridge's mind later this week. In the meantime, Zoe Buckingham will fail to convince Carter Walton to trust her again. Carter will maintain that the engagement's off, so it looks like Zoe will have no choice but to hand over the ring like he demanded. The Bold and the Beautiful spoilers say Carter will refuse to listen to Zoe's begging and will completely shut her out of his life. After Zoe realizes her life has completely blown up, she'll find Paris Buckingham to play the blame game. Zoe will feel like none of this would have happened if Paris hadn't shown up and started causing drama. Zoe might act like Paris provoked her by taking an interest in Zen Forrester Dominguez. From Zoe's perspective, she might argue she would have been able to move past her feelings for Zen if Paris hadn't stirred the pot. Zoe may bring up the history she's alluded to before and insist that Paris always finds a way to mess things up for her. Naturally, Paris won't stand there and let Zoe hold her responsible. Paris certainly didn't force Zoe to sashay her way to the Forrester mansion and throw herself at Zen. Zoe was the one who made a commitment to Carter and broke it behind his back, and with a good friend of Carter's no less. Paris will feel like Zoe should look in the mirror if she wants someone to blame, so this sister war will definitely heat up on Thursday. Hope tried to calm Liam as he nervously checked his phone for a message from Steffi. Eventually, Steffi called Liam to tell him that the paternity test was done and that Dr. Campbell had ordered a rush on the results. The results, however, would not be available until at least the following day. If you believe in mother's intuition, then you and Hope have nothing to worry about, Steffi said reassuringly. Liam told Steffi to call him when she had any more information, then hung up the phone. As he did, Thomas popped his head in the door and expressed his surprise that Steffi had already gotten a paternity test. Thomas apologized for barging in. Hope explained that the sooner everyone knew the truth, the sooner everyone could move on. Thomas assured Liam that he was not getting any pleasure from Liam's predicament. Thomas then turned to Hope and praised her strength, telling her that she and Liam could get through whatever the paternity test showed. Later, Hope and Liam discussed Thomas. With the conversation edging toward the possibility of an argument, Liam pivoted. He told Hope that the only thing he wanted to focus on was earning Hope's forgiveness. Hope didn't immediately respond to Liam's claim that she was his top priority. Hope responded that she needed to wait until the test results came back. Liam promised to spend the rest of his life proving how much he loved Hope. Thomas met up with Vinny. Vinny apologized for not being around for Thomas in his time of need. Vinny then reached into his pocket and removed a bottle of prescription grade, straight from the source pills and offered them to Thomas as a make good. Thomas said that he wanted no part of the pills because of what he'd seen Steffi go through. Vinny sensed something was bothering Thomas. Thomas shared that Steffi was pregnant and unsure of the father of the child. Thomas brought Vinny up to speed. Vinny mentioned that depending on how the paternity test results played out, Thomas could have an open field to pursue Hope. At the Cliff House, Brooke let herself in, telling Steffi that she had knocked but not gotten a response. "I know what you did to my daughter," Brooke said icily. She then demanded to know why Steffi had slept with Liam. Steffi denied wanting to destroy Hope's marriage, but Brooke insinuated that that was exactly what Steffi wanted. Brooke rattled off numerous other ways that Steffi could have helped other than being a friend with benefits. Steffi informed Brooke of the paternity test and her instinct that the baby was Finn's. Once she learned that Ridge didn't know what was going on, Steffi asked Brooke not to say anything. Brooke agreed, but instructed Steffi to tell Ridge the whole story. even if the paternity test showed that Finn was the father. Brooke sensed that Steffi was struggling with the situation. Brooke assured Steffi that she didn't want to stress Steffi out. Steffi countered that Brooke choosing a surprise confrontation wasn't exactly soothing. Brooke fired back that she could not have sat idly by after Steffi had slept with Liam. I expected a little understanding coming from a woman who... Steffi halted when Brooke groaned loudly. Before leaving, Brooke said that Steffi better be right that Finn was the baby's father. At Forrester Creations, Paris watched quietly as Zen looked over some dresses on a rack. Paris sensed that something was on Zen's mind. Not something. Someone, Zen replied. Paris questioned if Zen hadn't been truthful when he'd said that his flirty little games with Zoe were over. Zen assured her that whatever had been going on between him and Zoe was finished. Zen worried that whatever Carter and Zoe had might be over too. Zen then remarked that it was such a waste for Carter to break up with Zoe, since the flirting with Zoe was over. Zen then turned the conversation by stating that he wanted to try to be a better man for Paris. I need to know, Carter said, asking, am I the man you want to marry? Zoe immediately replied that he was. Carter followed up his question with another, why? Zoe seemed taken aback by the question. Rather than answer directly, Zoe said that there were many reasons. Pressed for at least one reason, Zoe responded that Carter was kind. Zoe continued to struggle with her response. Carter then asked if Zoe wanted to marry him because he was gullible. Carter told Zoe what Ridge had told him. Zoe said she could explain everything. Zoe swore that nothing was happening between her and Zen. Make me understand why you're throwing yourself at Zen while you're engaged to me? Carter roared. Admitting that it had been inappropriate, Zoe claimed that she had been trying to gauge what Zen had been thinking. Zoe told Carter that she was in love with Carter and how proud she was of everything that he had accomplished. You're only with me because I am Forrester adjacent, Carter snapped, adding that Zoe would drop him in a minute if she could have the real thing. He then recalled how quick Zoe had been to agree to marry Thomas. Zoe denied Carter's accusation, but Carter's rage continued to grow. He blasted himself for not realizing that Zoe had never had any interest in him. If you want him, you can have him, Carter snarled, declaring, the engagement is off. We're done. Zoe begged Carter to reconsider. Carter told Zoe she could take off her ring, and they could pretend their engagement had never happened. I loved you. I wanted to start a life with you, Zoe. I don't fall in love easily, Carter said with tears in his eyes. Zoe vowed to make Carter see that she loved him. Maybe it was just because I felt like me and you were moving so fast, Zoe explained. Zoe told Carter that she'd gotten over that fear and wanted nothing more than to be his wife. Carter stood before her, silent and motionless. At the cabin, Liam takes a call from Steffi as Hope listens. She updates him that the paternity test has been done and Dr. Campbell's putting a rush on it. Liam disconnects and fills Hope in as Thomas arrives. He's surprised to hear Steffi took a paternity test already. Liam confirms it and muses that now all they can do is wait. Thomas explains he'd normally come for Liam but right now he's just concerned about Steffi and that little baby inside of her. He's there for both Hope and Liam whatever they need and reminds Hope she's strong. No matter what the paternity test results show. Thomas leaves and Hope reiterates to Liam that he wants them to get through this. Liam feels time will tell if he means what he says. Right now, he only cares about Hope's opinion. And ultimately, her forgiveness. Hope just wants the baby to be Finn's. Liam vows to spend the rest of his life proving himself to her regardless. I love you. I always will. Brooke arrives at Steffi's house and intones, I know what you did to my daughter. She accuses Steffi of wanting the baby to be Liam's so she can take him away from Hope. Brooke proceeds to go over all the things Steffi could have done other than drink with Liam while comforting him. Steffi says she was being a friend. Brooke sneers, friend with benefits. Steffi insists she wants the child to be Finn's. Steffi asks if Ridge was there when Brooke found out. Brooke explains he wasn't and can see this is all weighing on Steffi. She has to keep her stress down and points out she came to attack her. She expects a little understanding from the woman who... Brooke throws up her hands and grimaces, oh God. She reiterates that Steffi slept with her daughter's husband and warns that baby better be Finn's and not Liam's. In Brooke's living room, Finny apologizes to Thomas for not being around more and offers him some drugs. Thomas refuses given what Steffi went though. Finny senses something's going on. Thomas admits Steffi's pregnant. Finny marvels that the doctor works fast. Thomas confides that the baby might be Liam's. As they discuss the paternity test, Finny points out that if Steffi's carrying Liam's baby, it could change everything for Thomas. Hope could finally be yours. It all depends on the results of the paternity test. in the Forrester Creations studio, Paris confronts an intense end who admits he's thinking about Zoe. He clarifies that whatever was going on between them is over, but her relationship with Carter may be over too. He feels it's a waste since Zoe's committed to Carter, but Paris wonders if that's enough for Carter. Zen turns the conversation to them. If Paris hasn't written him off, he'd still like to get to know her better. In the main office, Zoe scrambles as Carter asks her to list the reason she wants to marry him. Growing angrier, Carter demands to know if she wants to marry him or Zen. He relays that Ridge told him what he walked in on and fumes, "I want to know what's been going on behind my back." He points out that if Zen had wanted something to happen, it would have. Zoe can't deny it. Carter rages at her to explain why she's throwing herself at Zen when she's engaged to him. As Zoe attempts to convince him of her love, it dawns on Carter that she started showing interest in him when he was promoted. He realizes she wanted him because he was Forrester adjacent, but she'd actually rather have the real thing. It's why she jumped at the chance to marry Thomas. "What you really want is to be a Forrester." Carter fumes. He curses himself for being so stupid and informs Zoe if she wants Zen, she can have him. Zoe protests, but Carter cuts her off and states, "We're not getting married, Zoe." Zoe doesn't want to give up on them, but Carter says she already did. He chokes up over how difficult this is for him. He doesn't fall in love easily. Zoe insists she can convince him of her sincerity. She only went to Zen because they were moving fast and she was scared. "I want a life with you, and only you, Carter. Please tell me you still want that."